Going tubeless is a great way to improve the puncture resistance of your tyres, but if you're put off by the complexity, don't be, because it's easy. First up, you'll need to check your rim and tyre compatibility. Both tyres and rims will often have whether they're tubeless compatible written on them. You'll need to make sure both of these will work with a tubeless setup, otherwise they won't be airtight and they won't seal. Second, get prepared. You do need some extra bits to convert a tubed setup to tubeless. You'll definitely need some tubeless valves, though they often come with a new bike, even if it runs inner tubes. Valves come in different stem lengths, so make sure yours are long enough to fit through your rims. You'll also need some tubeless sealant. This helps the tyre inflate by sealing small holes in the tyre and also any punctures further down the line. Now you'll need to make sure your wheel and tyre are clean. This will make the process much easier. Lastly, you'll need a high quality track pump, ideally one that has a tubeless inflator built in, like this MERIDA Tubeless Floor Pump. This has a special reservoir that you charge with high pressure air and a switch on the head to release it all in one go. It makes the job of getting the tyres seated onto the rims and inflated much, much easier, so it's a bit of a must have. Third, get rid of the tubes. This is the simple bit. Just remove your inner tube in the normal way. If you're keeping the same tyres on, then try and only remove one side of the tyre bead, as this will make reinflating them much easier. Four, add in the valves and tubeless sealant. This is the messy part, so it's best to do this outdoors. The valves are easy. Many have different rubber bungs to suit different rim beds, so choose one that it looks like it'll be a good fit for your rim. Tighten them down well, as they can be a major source of air leaks and a real reason that you can't get your tubeless setup to work. The sealant manufacturer will suggest a recommended amount to add, so you should use that as a guideline. We would always suggest being on the generous side, as this can make life much easier. Five. Reseat the tyre and spread the sealant around. Now you need to carefully reseat the bead of the tyre using tyre levers as necessary. Try and work evenly around the rim, finishing at the valve. When the bead is on the rim, rotate the wheel to distribute the sealant around the tyre. This will help the tyre seat on the bead if you use a cloth or a sponge with a bit of soapy water to help lubricate the rim and tyre bead. Six, add air. Now put on your pump. We've charged the MERIDA tubeless pump to the maximum 260 PSI, so it's good to go. All you need to do is just flick the lever and the tyre should seat. Now, listen for air leaks, look for sealant leaks, and make sure that the tyre bead is seated by visually checking that this line is even around the tyre. If it isn't, add more pressure. The bead often pings into place with a loud noise. Don't worry, this is totally normal. We'd suggest inflating your tyres to higher than your normal pressures, giving them a spin and then leaving them for a while to ensure that the tyre is holding air. Then you just need to adjust it to your normal pressures and then you can get on with enjoying your riding, hopefully with far fewer punctures than before. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you have, feel free to give it a like. For more how-to videos, check out our playlist here. And to keep up to date with everything else MERIDA, subscribe to our channel here. If you want to know more about the MERIDA tubeless pump, then check the link in the description down below. Anyway, thanks for watching and we'll see you next time.